Hi everybody. Today we're going to continue learning about data structures and algorithms. Specifically, we are learning about P versus NP. So far, we've seen a lot of good news, like such and such a problem can be solved quickly. That means in linear time, or at least a time that is a small polynomial function. NP completeness is a form of our bad news. It's going to show evidence that many important problems can't be solved quickly. So first, let's define what P and NP are. Class P problems are problems that can be solved in polynomial time. So that means it can be solved in a linear time or some type of polynomial function like n squared or n to the cube. Class P problems are deterministic algorithms. That means these algorithms behave predictably. Class NP problems stand for non-deterministic polynomial time. A non-deterministic algorithm uses some type of operations to guess what to do next when a decision is made. And it can exhibit different behaviors each time it is ran. A problem is NP if you can quickly, in polynomial time, test whether the solution is correct. And that means you don't worry about how hard it might be to actually figure out the solution. We also have NP complete. NP complete problems are the hardest problems in an NP set. A decision problem is NP complete if it is in NP. See, so we have NP and then N compute, which means any given solution for NP complete problems can be verified quickly, but there is no efficiently known solution. And every problem in NP is reducible to polynomial time. All NP complete problems are equivalent computationally. A problem is NP hard if it follows only the second property of what we mentioned above, which means every problem in NP is reducible to polynomial time. And NP complete, the NP complete set, is a subset of NP hard. You can also see here that P is a subset of NP, which means that any problem that can be solved by deterministic machines in polynomial time can also be solved by non-deterministic machines in polynomial time. There's also another belief that P is actually not in NP, and this is a famous open problem in computer science. You can actually make $1 million if you can prove that P is in NP or P is not in NP. It's one of the famous $1 million unsolved problems in computer science. So if you're feeling ambitious and probably further on into maybe your PhD career, you can maybe take up the gambit and try to prove whether P is NP or P is not NP. So I've talked about P and NP and NP complete and NP hard problems, but that's kind of hard to grasp, right? Let's talk about it in the sense of example problems. What is a P problem? A problem that can be solved in polynomial time would be something like determining if a string is a palindrome. That means the front to back equals back to front. You just flip the two, compare them. Find if a string is contained in another string. That's basically searching the string for the other string. You can do that in n time. Determining if a number is prime. You're going to divide until you divide by certain factors until you determine if it's prime or not, because it won't be able to be divided, right? Those are set examples that can be done in polynomial time. So now let's look at some example NP complete problems. Now remember, no problem can be NP complete without it being NP and NP hard based off of what we saw before. There are some very famous problems within NP complete. We have the traveling salesman problem, which states, given a list of cities and distances between each of the pair of cities, what's the shortest possible route that visits every city exactly once, and then you're able to return to your original city. In this case, you have to analyze all the possible routes in order to figure it out, and there's no real polynomial time that it can be solved in. So you open up an array of possible abilities, and the list of routes is super long, but if you look at just the solution and then you check if that's right, it's a very fast and it's able to be solved in polynomial time. The traveling salesman problem is actually a very famous problem, and you'll run across it potentially when you're out in the field working as a software engineer, because it has several applications. Like, you end up using this within planning and logistics and just manufacturing different items. So this problem isn't unique. Other NP complete problems are the knapsack problem, which is that you're given a set of items and each have a weight and a value, and then you need to determine each item to include in a collection so that the total weight is less than or equal to a given limit, and the total value is as large as possible. Another example of NP complete problems is the click problem. And this is a computational problem that involves finding clicks, which are subsets of vertices all adjacent to each other in graphs. So there's a lot of different NP complete problems. I just gave three examples, but these NP complete problems you actually do run across within your career. An example of an NP hard problem that is not NP is the halting problem. The halting problem says, given a specific program and its input, will it run forever or halt? That is an NP hard problem. Yes, no, yes, no answer that can only be solved really by putting in the input and then finding out. So why does this all matter? Well, as I said before, NP complete problems come up all the time. So knowing that they exist and they're hard to solve saves you time to work on a compromise for that solution. So some workarounds are using heuristics. If you can't solve the problem with a good worst case time, maybe you can come up with a method for solving it in a reasonable fraction of a common cases. You can solve the problem approximately. So a lot of time, the problem comes up with a probable fast algorithm. And maybe it doesn't solve exactly what you want for your solution, but you can make it close enough. You can use the exponential time solution anyways. If you really have to solve the problem exactly as it is, you can settle on the fact that you're gonna have to write this exponential problem in exponential time and stop worrying about trying to find a better solution or to find a better abstraction. It's possible that the NP complete problem you're trying to solve happened because you're ignoring some seemingly unimportant detail that would actually help narrow it down. So I'll give an example. In my career, I've run across several NP complete problems. One is the traveling salesman problem. CTO came to me because they wanted to find the nurse that was closest to a patient so they could travel to their house and administer medicine. So we have a list of hundreds of nurses all over the United States, and we need to find the nurse that's closest to that patient. And the line that my CTO said was, it's not a big deal, it's just a traveling salesman problem. Which my response was, it's famous for a reason, because we have to look at every single nurse. So I started asking more questions. Can every nurse administer medication to the patient? No, they have to be certified for certain things. So that narrowed down the list of nurses. They have to be certified to work in that state. Well, now we're narrowing down the nurses that can be in that specific state that the patient is in. they also have to be working on specific days. So that narrows it down even more. And slowly we brought the problem down. Yes, still an exponential time, but we narrowed the subset down so that it was a lot smaller. And then we're only looking at about 5 nurses within a city that can help the patient, not looking at the every single nurse within the United States. So now you have a better understanding of P and NP problems. In our next video, you are going to learn about linked lists. Happy learning!